Greetings. Well, let's continue our walk through Revelation at chapter 12. I want to clearly state my current thinking on this very interesting chapter. Almost a year ago, I came across the information of the astronomical alignment of Revelation 12:1. And though skeptical at first, I could not refute it, nor could I dismiss it from my consciousness. But there is something to keep in mind. God can intend more than one meaning in a passage of Scripture. And I think the classical interpretation of Revelation 12:1-17 still must be understood. So I'd like to dig into the detail of this chapter in a little more detail, lest the broader message be lost in space. 12:1. And there appeared a great wonder in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun and the moon under her feet, and upon her head a crown of 12 stars. I believe the common interpretation of this imagery descends from the interpretations of Joseph's vision. Genesis 37:9. Then he had another dream, and he told it to his brothers. Listen, he, this is Joseph, said, I had another dream, and this time the sun and moon and 11 stars were bowing down to me. In his dream, the sun is Abraham, the moon is Sarah, and the 11 stars are the other sons of Abraham. And this makes it very easy to associate this interpretation with the sun, moon, and 12 stars in Revelation. And clearly, if you read all of Revelation 12, the woman is an imagery of Israel. And how great is our God that he may tell this story and cause the sun and moon and stars to depict it. And she, being with child, cried, travailing in birth, and pained to be delivered. And the common understanding of this is that Jesus is the child, the son, brought forth from the nation of Israel. But this verse also has a fascinating fulfillment in the retrograde motion of Jupiter within the womb of Virgo for 9 months, which would be a fascinating pattern all by itself. But when coupled with the stellar alignment of September 23rd, 2017, the sun, moon, and 12 stars, along with the constellation Virgo, one can only mutter, Dear God, have you made it that obvious? So heed the stars, but do not forget the very real interpretation that Jesus is the child of the promise of God made to humanity through Israel. 12:3. And there appeared another wonder in heaven, and behold, a great red dragon having 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns upon his heads. The classic meaning of this is describing Satan, the devil, as the dragon, which we learn in verse 9. The meanings of the heads and horns and crowns have had various interpretations, and I think are still not absolutely known. I've also seen a video regarding this verse about the dragon and constellations. And honestly, it felt like a stretch to me. Do not get me wrong, it may be right on. I am not the final arbiter of truth. The Holy Spirit is. But I can rationalize that if September 23rd, 2017 fulfills Revelation 12:1, the Holy Spirit can teach me before verse 3 is fulfilled. 12:4, And his tail drew the third part of the stars of heaven and did cast them to the earth, and the dragon stood before the woman which was ready to be delivered for to devour her child as soon as it was born. Verse 4 continues with evidence that this teaches of Satan and his angels that followed him. We now call these spirits demons. And it begins to reveal why Israel has been the focus of evil and hatred for 6,000 years. Satan knows that Israel is the channel for God to interact with humanity according to his promises. Ever since God made covenant with Abraham and swore Isaac would have the eternal covenant. 12:5. And she brought forth a man-child, who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron. And her child was caught up unto God and to his throne. Ultimately, Jesus was born, and Jesus ascended up to God to be seated at the right hand of the Father until his enemies be made his footstool. Writing that gave me a very peculiar idea, to call people footstool when they oppose the gospel. But that is just the part of me that is still not perfected in the love of God. 12:6. And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she hath a place prepared of God, that they should feed her there 1,260 days. And from here on in the chapter, this seems to be prophetic, speaking of future deliverance and protection for Israel, the woman. I have not found any astronomical theories regarding this and subsequent verses, and I think it would be difficult to form a plausible one. The stated time is clearly coincidental, and I'm being sarcastic, with 1,260 days being exactly 3 1/2 360-day years. And half of 7 years happens to be the same period, 3 1/2 years, 7 years being the length of Jacob's trouble. But one mystery of this verse to me is who they are. And the woman fled into the wilderness, where she has a place prepared of God, that they should feed her there 1,260 days. Angels? Christians? Others? Perhaps this detail has no particular significance. Verse 7. And there was war in heaven. Michael and his angels fought against the dragon, and the dragon fought and his angels. More clarity is added here. The dragon has angels in his army. And prevailed not, neither was their place found any more in heaven. That's a nice way of saying the devil got his hat handed to him. They were shown the door. And the great dragon was cast out, that old serpent called the devil and Satan, which deceives the whole world. He was cast out into the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. And this is often taught as a past event, not something in the future. This interpretation arises because we believe Jesus described it. Luke 10:18, and he said to them, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. But then you read the next verse, and perhaps it does not seem so long ago in the distant past. And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven, Now is come salvation and strength, and the kingdom of our God, and the power of his Christ. For the accuser of our brethren is cast down, which accused them before our God day and night. So was Jesus speaking prophetically of a future event he knew was coming? I cannot say for certain. Does this passage in Revelation ignore time because it is irrelevant in the heavenlies? Again, I cannot declare so with absolute certainty. We can say with certainty Satan loses, and from our perspective has already lost. Colossians 2:15, And having spoiled principalities and powers, he made a show of them openly, triumphing over them in it. And they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb, and by the word of their testimony, and they loved not their lives unto the death. You know how I love pronouns. So I've highlighted the few here. First, note him is singular. Since they overcame him, him was defeated. Him is obviously the dragon from this context, the devil, Satan. They, however, deserve a little more thoughtful analysis. They, number one, use the blood of the Lamb. Number two, they testify. And number three, they have death. They can die. Given that, it does not make sense to look back and apply Michael and angels as the antecedent. Angels cannot die. nor are angels associated with the blood of the Lamb. I therefore believe they are believers, Jewish believers in Yeshua. And I get that from Revelation 12:17, which I'll just jump ahead to right now. And the dragon was wroth with the woman. Remember, the woman is Israel, and went to make war with the remnant of her seed. Even now, Satan is trying to kill all of the Jews. But here is the evidence that makes my point, which keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. The remnant has the testimony of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah! God will honor his covenant with Isaac forever. Back to verse 12. Therefore rejoice, you heavens, and you that dwell in them. And woe to you inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is coming down to you having great wrath, because he knows that he has but a short time. At this point, Satan has to know he only has 3.5 years to go. And when the dragon saw that he was cast onto earth, he persecuted the woman, meaning Israel, which brought forth the man-child. And the woman were given 2 wings of a great eagle, that she might fly into the wilderness, into her place, where she is nourished for a time and times and half a time from the face of the serpent. And the serpent cast out of his mouth water as a flood after the woman, that he might cause her to be carried away of the flood. Is this a literal flood of water, or symbolic of tens of millions of Mohammedans attacking Israel? We shall have to wait and see. And the earth helped the woman, and the earth opened her mouth, and swallowed up the flood which the dragon cast out of his mouth. Even this continuation of the imagery of a flood can be literal or metaphorical. And the dragon was wroth with the woman, and went to make war with the remnant of her seed, which keep the commandments of God and have the testimony of Jesus Christ. I hope I didn't spoil the punchline. They have the testimony of Jesus Christ. This was supposed to be an overview of Revelation, but I think chapter 12 provides an interesting intermission. I'll continue on to chapter 13 in the next part. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.